come on, I'm just saying, I've worked plenty of cases with you in the past, but this is the first time you hung your investigator on my neck.
I thought he could help.
Help with what?
He had a benefit of an hourly update.
Exactly.
Come on, guys. She thought her defendant had killed a sitting judge. I'd want all hands on deck, too.
Thank you, Pops. Yeah,
especially when you're dealing with a monster like her.
Whoa. How could she be a monster if she hasn't been convicted of a monstrous crime, which she hasn't yet, right?
Walks like a duck.
Alleged monster, okay?
Okay.
Okay, but how do you make that call on yourself?
What call?
Whether some personal investment is interfering with following protocol.
I didn't cross a line, if that's what you're saying.
I hear things. You went to the ME to discuss the cause of death.
I was checking in on the status of a case.
Checking in on or leaning on?
Checking in.
Right.
What's going on here, an inquisition? Has no one at this table leaned in hard on something that mattered to them?
There is a difference, and I think everyone here knows that.
Yeah, including me.
But sometimes the ends justify the means. Don't look so surprised.
I'm not surprised. I'm sure there's been a time where you had to make the end justify the means.
What about you, Jamie?
Let's just say some things I regretted at the time, but none of it to this day.
Wow. Once a lawyer, always a lawyer.
Yeah, and how about you, Grams?
What he said.
Danny?
I'll take the fifth.
I could justify just about any means to put an end to income inequality.
How fitting it is that you are now sitting on my left.
So this started with me. How about you?
If there was a probability that doing the so-called right thing might jeopardize the safety of the public or my officers, I think I could come around to justifying the means to the end.
At any cost to you?
I don't think you can make that measurement until you come right up against it.
I need to say something, but I need you to pay attention because you may never hear it again.
Okay.
I was wrong.
Wow. You know, I haven't heard you utter those words since I was 9 years old when you stole my baseball cards and sold them behind my back.
I really needed a new Walkman.
Yeah, right.
I took a statement from a girl who had been sold into prostitution by Chow. When she was 13. 13. And she, like hundreds of other girls like her, had their lives destroyed.
And Chow should rot in hell. Look, some perps, they get under your skin, especially the bad ones.
I was sure that Chow had done it.
Don't beat yourself up.
Tesler dying exactly when it's most convenient to Chow, who has no issue threatening public officials.
Chow threatened Judge Tesler.
No, she threatened me.
What are you talking about?
The first time was at a plea conference. The second time was the other night.
So you were threatened more than once. Is that what you're telling me? What happened?
They followed me, left Chow's calling card on my windshield.
And you didn't think to tell me?
You just tried to scare me off the case, Danny.
Did you at least tell the court officer in your building? No, you didn't, because you didn't want to be removed from the case. When did this happen?
Thursday night.
Thursday night? Thursday night is when we brought Wheeler in for questioning. When Chow's people had to know about that.
So?
So why would they risk threatening you? If Wheeler already confessed, then Chow was in the clear.
Because they didn't know what Wheeler had told you.
And because they had something to hide about the judge's death.
The ruling on the motion for mistrial is being handed down tomorrow morning.
Well, you better stall it, because this isn't over yet.